So the past couple of weeks, we've been talking about being childlike. And I know that's not the easiest thing for some of us to think about. You know, myself, I feel like a grown-up sometimes. Sometimes I still feel like a kid, you know, not in the good ways either. You know, like, oh, you know, feel a little insecure, you know, even as we get older. And I'm, you know, getting up there around, you know, be 40 in a couple of years. And I'm like, man, I mean, I know that's not that old, guys, but like, sometimes I feel like, am I as mature as all these other people? I mean, I feel so immature, you know, and do I know, you know, what I need to know? And are people, do they see me as somebody that, you know, that has it together and all these things? But so many times we have this air of pride or this thing, and we don't like to say we're prideful. I mean, I know I'm not prideful, but there's something about being teachable, being childlike, and allowing God to speak to us and to teach us that is basically the basis of really the underlying thing of the Bible. That the gospel message is really what the Bible is about. You know, going before Christ came up into that point where he came and did that miraculous work on the cross, and then after that how life changed and how we're different because of it. All that's about, you know, the gospel, but underlying so many times throughout the Bible we hear these scriptures and we read them and it's God saying, listen to what I'm saying, hear me, see me, you know, do you see what I'm gonna do? You know, all these things. And I think about that, and I think God's trying to get us to be students of his. Are we listening? Are we hearing? We have to be teachable. But so many times we grow up and you know, I know we don't like to grow up, and then we do like to grow up, and there's so many different things about it, but we grow up and then we feel like, you know, I've got things together. I've got to figure it out. You know, I went to school and I've got a good job and things are going well. But we become hardened to the fact that we don't know everything. We want to feel like we know what's going on. But we never can know what is the fullness of God's call for our life or what he has for us. We never can know all of who he is, the fullness of who God is. Don't come to me and tell me that you know who God is. You know kind of about him and things about him, glimpses of who he is, but I would venture to say if you knew everything of who God was, you'd probably drop dead on the spot, you know? I mean, the fullness of who he is, we cannot comprehend, which means that we need to continually be learning and growing in him, being teachable. And I know we want to feel like, you know, we stop this learning process. I didn't want, you know, to continue to go to school and get my master's and my doctorate and all this stuff. I mean, who knows? Maybe I will someday when I grow up. But, you know, I'm like, you know, I'm ready to go do this. And some people, God bless you. If you want to stay in school your whole life, you're awesome. But God spoke to me and he said, look, you may not be in this natural university or school, he said, but I'm going to tell you, you're in school your entire life. Your life is school. Your life is learning who I am and learning how to act like Jesus. Your life is learning how to walk with me. And if you ever feel like you got the degree on that, you're wrong. You know, you don't finish that degree until we go to meet the Lord and we see him. And your life is school, I'm sorry to say. I mean, I didn't like it at first either. But we need to be teachable. We need to learn constantly and grow in God and walk like him and talk like him and just be learning every single day of our lives. Amen? I knew that one wasn't going to be that strong, but it's all right. It's okay. hopefully after this message, you'll be a little bit happier about it. Matthew 18:4, it says, "Therefore, whoever humbles himself as a little child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven." Whoever humbles himself. And like I said, we don't like to think of ourselves as being prideful, and we say, no, I'm not prideful. But listen to the definitions here of being humble. To bring down one's pride, that one's like, you know, I don't feel prideful, but to have a modest opinion of oneself, to behave in an unassuming manner, or devoid of all haughtiness. See, these other things, it's, you know, we're like, no, I'm not prideful. But sometimes we want to feel highly of ourselves. We want, you know, to feel like we've got it all together. And it's not that we shouldn't feel like we've got it together, but we should feel like we've got it together because of God. And because he's teaching us, because he's helping us, because he's speaking to us. Not because we got it all together. Not because of who we are, but because of who he is. Because he's teaching us and helping us to grow. I mean, have you ever seen little kids? I know you either have had a little kid, a toddler, or you were one. So, you know, you may remember that if you were one. But as little kids, as these, you know, what is it, 4 or 5, you know, they've learned words like love and kindness and all these different words that you've been teaching your toddlers. And then they learn the meaning behind them, like love. It's like they know what love is, and then they learn what love is, like what the meaning behind it. It's, well, love means that my parents love me. They come and kiss me. They hug me. I've grasped a little bit what love is. But then you continue to grow, and as you grow older, and then they learn more of these concepts and these bigger ideas about what love is. Because with love, you know, as a parent, we discipline our kids, not because, well, hopefully not because we're angry with them, but because we love them, that we teach them and we protect them because we love them. And those are things that they continue to learn and grow in. But, you know, sometimes I feel like as an adult, we learn something about the Word of God and we're like, oh, I see that word. I see that word, and then I learn what that word means. But sometimes we stop there at the word and the meaning when God wants to teach us a whole big concept about what that scripture means and that word. And, you know, I was thinking about Pastor Ryan this morning, the scripture that he said he was reading, and they were anxiously looking for Jesus. And we've all read that, most of us, I'm sure read that scripture many times, but if Pastor Ryan wasn't coming with the teachable open mind as he's reading the Bible, see, that word wouldn't have popped out to him. That those revelations that came to him in that moment, they just kind of exploded in his mind because he was open and receptive to learning something new. He could have just read right through it and been like, man, they were a little anxious, you know, going, looking for Jesus. They're kind of scared, you know, yeah, whatever. But God just threw something out to him and he just grasped it because he was being teachable, because he was being open about the things of God and allowing God to share something new, a new revelation, a new thought. You know, this scripture that we read, it's amazing. We can read through the whole Bible. We can even memorize the whole Bible. But you can't know completely all the revelations and things that God wants to pull out of there. So don't ever come to your Bible thinking like, I've read it before. You've read the words, but you haven't read the revelation that God wants to give you in that moment. But we can come and say, I've read it before. I'm not being teachable anymore. Am I going to allow God to throw something out there that I've never seen? I've read the scripture, but I haven't seen this. Because it's a new thing that he wants to teach me. Are we being teach? Are we coming as those toddlers? Why? You know, they ask thousands of questions a day. You know, I read a statistic one time, and I don't remember how much it was, but they ask why and how and what like hundreds upon hundreds of times a day. Because they're absorbing all this information, and they need it to grow and to not be stunted in learning at a specific age. They continue to ask and question and be like, tell me something new that I don't know. Imagine if a child, for whatever reason, isn't able to or doesn't learn after a certain point, and they grow older, but they're very immature. I'm sorry, but sometimes we do that as adults. Sometimes we do that as Christians. We stunt our growth. We're still little babies, and it's not that we don't grow up. We do. We do become experts at who God is and knowing Him, but there's something about being an expert that I loved. I grabbed a quote in this article on expertise, and it says this: being a true expert means having a healthy dose of humility. If you have really studied something and really gone deep into how it works, then you should come away knowing how much you don't know. In a sense, that is the real definition of an expert: knowing the limits of one's own knowledge. Ha, look at that. So it's not that you're not an expert. You can become an expert in who God is, in the Bible, and knowing all these things. But as an expert, what this person is, I can't remember the guy's name, but as he was explaining, he's like, you can become an expert. You can learn so many things, but as an expert, you should realize that you can never attain all that knowledge, and you should always yearn for growing and learning more. That's what being an expert is. Yeah, you grow up and learn and grow, but growing up and becoming older, we should not stop learning, but know that we need to learn more. Seeking for that revelation of who God is, knowing Him more. Yes, I know so much of you. That's why I want to know more, because I know that I can't know it all. Like, that should be our life. I'm sorry. We got to go back to school. Got to go back to school. Well, we should just yearn for learning more of who God is. 1 John 3, verse 2, it says, beloved, now we are children of God. Now we are children. I know. It's like, We're children again. We're the babies again. He says, we're children of God, and it has not yet been revealed what we shall be. But we know that when He is revealed, we shall be like Him, for we shall see Him as He is. It has not yet been revealed what we shall be. He's saying, guys, don't act like you got it all figured out. Don't think you've got it all figured out. Yes, we can become experts, but guys, you don't understand. You can't completely comprehend who God is or who you are in Christ to the fullest until way later, whenever He's revealed. We'll see Him and see how we're like Him. There's something that we will know later on. But until that point, until we're with Him and He's revealed to us, until that point, strive and yearn and just, go learn. Ask questions. What happened to the what's and why's and how's? As we get older, we're like, we don't ask those questions so much anymore because we want to feel like we know, you know? Like, are we coming to God and saying, God, what about this? God, what does this mean? You know, when we ask questions, more times than not, it's like, hey, God, you know, help me out with my finances. can you help me with this relationship? Or will you do this for me? And will you do that? There's times for that. But in our conversations with God and our moments with Him as we're seeking Him, it should be, God, what is something that I don't know about You? What is something that You can just reveal to me in this scripture that I'm reading? What does this mean? And How am I doing things right and how am I doing things wrong? God, and see, that's where the problem is when we start asking the hard questions, things might get a little tough. What if God says, well, you're not really walking this out the right way. You need to change the direction you're going. That's the problem. As we get older, we're like, we're on this path. We're moving forward, whether it's our job, our family, you know, and with our walk, you know, with him. And we know who he is and we're learning more. But if we ask him something that we don't know, it might change us and it's hard. Am I going to let him change me? Am I going to let him reveal something to me that might change the way I think or the way I walk or how I react to things? It's tough. But as kids in school, that's what we have to be. As we grow up, that's who we are. We're learning things in school and from our parents. We're asking questions. We're hearing all these things about here's how you live and here's what you need in your life. And here's all. We can't stop that as we grow older. We can't stop learning and knowing God more and knowing the way to live. We won't ever comprehend it. So don't try. Just ask for more and more and more of him. Learn, be teachable, be humble. Don't let pride get a hold of you. Pride makes us hard to the thought of learning something that might change us. But I don't know about you, but I know God is good. I know he has the best for me. And if God has to change you or I, it's going to be for the better. It might not be easy, but it's going to be so good. If he wants to change you and he wants to give you something that you need to know to revolutionize your life, it might not look like you thought it was going to look, but it's going to be better. It's like parents, it's my kids, you know, sometimes I tell them stuff. It's like, this is what you need to know. It doesn't feel great to them at the time, but I know that it's going to make them better. It's going to be more fulfilling. It's going to help them as they grow up and grow in life. Because I know a little bit more about life than they do. Let me tell you, God knows a little bit more about life than you do. Are we allowing him to teach us? As we grow in God, becoming an expert, if you will, it doesn't mean we don't need to learn. It just means we realize how much we don't know. But being teachable has a lot to do with humility, a lot to do with not putting ourselves up on this pedestal of what we've accomplished, but saying, God, help me to accomplish something. Help me, lead me, guide me. I need to know more. Psalm 25, it says, 25 verse 9, the humble he guides in justice, and the humble he teaches his way. Over and over and over, he says in the Bible, will you humble yourself to listen? Will you humble yourself to see what I want for you or what I am speaking to you? You know, we had this moment in the service that, you know, our pastor and I was like, let's just be here in the presence of God. And so many times it's hard for us these days to just sit in the quiet and listen. Has anybody ever noticed that? We've got the radio, Joy FM or whatever playing all the time in the car, and at home we'll crank up the stereo or turn on the news or doing all this stuff. And it's constantly coming at us, and it's, if we turn everything off, it's uncomfortable. But we need to turn everything off so that we can hear what he's saying. He says, will you listen to me? Will you see what I'm doing? Humble yourself. Don't think too highly of yourself. You're amazing. You're doing wonderfully. You are, oh, look at, you're my child. He's saying all these things. He said, but But just don't think too highly of yourself, because then when you start doing that and getting prideful, you close yourself off to hearing more. You close yourself off to learning more of who I am and seeing what I'm doing. Are you comfortable holding things loosely in your hand? Because see, God's given us great talents and great things to use in our life. He's taught us over the years how to live and how to move and to know Him. But can we hold those things with an open hand instead of a closed hand? Because just like me, there's constantly things that I'm trying to teach my kids. God is trying constantly to teach you things. And sometimes He's like, look, you're holding on so tight to this one thing. You're not allowing me to teach you new things. You're standing on this one thing that I did or this one thing that I showed you and standing on like it's a pedestal, like you're a statue, this monument to what I did this one time. And that's great. That thing that I was able to do in your life, but I want to do more. I want to move again in your life. But in order to move again in your life, I have to teach you more. I have to show you more. I have to talk to you, and you have to see new things about who I am. Don't just stand there like a monument to what I did some time in the past. But live your life open to learning and growing. Philippians 3:12. I love this. It's Paul. It's like one guy that had some, it's not the only guy, but one guy that you look at and you're like, man, God did amazing things in this guy's life. Radically changed him and just like worked in him in some crazy ways. But he says, not that I have already attained, where I'm already perfected, but I press on that I may lay hold of that for which Christ Jesus has also laid hold of me. Brethren, I don't count myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things which are ahead. I press toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Jesus Christ. It's not like we forget all the good things. We do remember what God has done, but He's telling us, He's like, look, you're just trying to hold on to those old things that God did. Don't you understand? He wants to do new things. He wants you to learn and to grow and not just stay in that place where you learn something and you're like, here it is. Here's God. I'm going to stay here. But God's not just in that one place. And that one thing that He taught you isn't just the revelation of a lifetime that you have to stay there. Can you open yourself up to knowing that God has more for you? He says, I just forget those things. I'm not holding on to them. I press forward toward the goal of that upward call of Christ Jesus. I will continue. He's like, I am never going to become stagnant. I'm never going to hold on to what I have so tight that it won't let me move forward. All I'm going to do is keep asking God to do more. Keep asking God to show me more of who He is. Keep asking God to speak to me. Keep asking God to do things in my life. He says, I'm not going to stay in this place. I've got to move forward. I've got to move forward. In Proverbs 8:32-34, it says, now therefore listen to me, my children, for blessed are those who keep my ways. Listen to me, my children, for blessed are those who keep my ways. A person who's willing to learn, will listen. It's hard. I know. We want to talk. We want to share what we know. This is what I did. This is what I know. It's like we're all wanting to talk, but the best learners are listeners. And God says, will you just sit and listen? Will you hear my voice? Remember, like the scripture, will you hear what I'm saying? Because I've told you many great things, but those aren't the only things. Don't stop listening. Continue to keep your ears open, your mind open to the new things that I will do. Verse 33, hear instruction and be wise, and do not disdain it. Hear instruction and be wise, and do not disdain it. How do you respond to correction? How is it that we respond? And again, like I said before, it's a little bit hard because when we start to open ourselves up to God speaking new things to us, what if he's going to correct me and tell me I'm not doing it the right way? What if he's going to tell me what I've been doing is not exactly what he wanted me to do? He wants me to do something else. What if? But he says, don't disdain correction. Don't look at it in a bad way, because look, if you're looking at that in a bad way, you're looking at God in a bad way. Do you trust that he loves you and that he cares for you and that he wants the best for you? My kids, I mean, sometimes they're like, I don't understand why you are yelling at me. I said, I actually didn't yell at you. I just told you what you did wrong. You know, maybe to you it sounds like yelling, but I mean, sometimes I raise my voice. I'm not saying I'll never raise my voice. But sometimes whenever I'm just telling my kids, I want to tell you why you're not supposed to do that. It's disrespectful and it's hurtful. Why are you yelling? You know, and I feel like sometimes as adults with God, we're like that. Oh God, why are you yelling at me? And he's like, all I did was told you you did something not in the right way, you know? But God, why are you treating me like this? I'm just trying to teach you. I'm just trying to show you that my ways are greater than your ways. That I love you and that I care for you. I mean, can we allow God to teach us, even if it is to change something about who we are or where we're going? Can we do that? Can we be teachable? Verse 34, blessed is the man who listens to me, watching daily at my gates, waiting at the post of my doors. Blessed is the man who listens to me, watching daily at my gates. When is it that we're listening and asking God to change us? Is it like every other Friday? Maybe once a month? I mean, I'm sorry to speak some of these things. They're a little bit hard to hear, but seriously, I'm preaching to myself. I get my head down. I'm saying, God, I'm doing this. This is what you've told me to do. And I start moving forward. And sometimes I realize that God's like, hey, knock, knock, wakey, wakey. Wakey, wakey. How long are you going to go just moving on that thing that I told you way back without listening to hear if there's anything else that I want to tell you? Are you coming to my door, knocking on my door? Are you waiting patiently for me to open the door every single day so that you can say, God, what next? God, what do you want me to do? Am I doing it the right way? Is there anything new that you want to tell me? He says, blessed is a man that listens, not only listens, but waits every single day at my doorstep, that comes to hear every single word that I have to say, ready, waiting for me. Not that I gotta have to go chase them down, but waiting for me to come and tell them something. He said, blessed is that man. Are we waiting at his doorsteps, ready for him to teach us and to show us some new revelation? And he's just like Pastor Ryan, it's like explodes in our mind. Are we allowing him to do that? Saying, God, I'm here. It's not the fourth Friday. It's just the next day. But you've asked me to come every day. You've asked me to come every day and learn something new about you. Allow you to teach me. Allow you to guide me. God, what do I need to learn? What do I need to know about you? What do I need to change about myself? I want to follow you. Why don't you stand with me?